Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Construction Simulator 2015 with me, BradM73. We are into September 2015 now, and it's been actually a really hot weekend here, so which has been nice. It's actually going to be starting to turn cooler, which is not nice, and I need to figure out what the heck I'm doing in this game. We don't have any special jobs. We just have like our normally available, whoops, contracts here. There's no active jobs. Let's go back. We're going to have new contracts available in another 4 minutes. So I'm thinking that, well, maybe I should just, we'll take another job and, I just don't know what to take. I'm gonna do like a little quickie one. So what I will do for this job is, let's see here. Active jobs. So the first stage we need to get rebar. So what I wanna do is I'm gonna hire a worker to do that. Now, it looks like I'll need to pump concrete in the second. Let's see here. Whoops, active jobs. Stage two, pour concrete. So, yeah, so what I'll do is we'll drive the concrete truck out to the job site. And we'll also need to get the concrete pump, or the concrete mixer there as well, which I don't know where that is. I think it might be up at the gravel plant. We need to figure out where we're going here. Okay, so right up here. Oh, time to get my Xbox controller out. There we go. So, I've been running Windows 10 for a couple of weeks now, and I am very strongly thinking about reverting back to Windows 8.1 because I've had some just really weird glitching on the desktop. For example, like my cursor gets glitchy, almost like, you know, you're playing a game at like 1.5 frames a second or something, and it's just random. There won't be any other, you know, anything else open except for like maybe GPU tweak and my, you know, my motherboard monitoring software, which, you know, could be an issue considering they're both. Well, I know Corsair Link is beta right now, but what is it? GPU tweak for the Asus video cards. That should be pretty stable. And I didn't have any problems with it under Windows 8.1. And so I'm thinking that that might be what the problem is, or part of the problem. A lot of people, I'm going to get a lot of crap for this, but I'm just going to say it. I use Internet Explorer because honestly, I don't really, I don't want to use Google Chrome because all of your browsing history, and there may be some way to turn it off that I just don't know about, but even then, I don't know. I don't trust Google. Let's just put it that way. I do not trust Google as a company. Maybe it's because they have a silly name. I don't know. But I just don't really trust them as a company. Other browsers like Opera are not really feature-rich enough to do what I need it to do. And then other browsers like Firefox are also kind of like, you know, sometimes they work okay, sometimes they're glitchy. But I, you know, Internet Explorer generally runs everything that I need it to run just fine. But this new Microsoft Edge thing is just, it's ridiculous. Maybe I don't get it. People are like, well, this is what Edge does. Well, it's like half the time you are, I don't even know how to describe. What are you doing, girl? Sorry, my dog's like underneath my desk. I don't know. It's just, it's like half the time you click on a web link and then it opens up a complete, like a new Edge window instead of a Internet Explorer window. And you're like, I don't need that. I want Internet Explorer. And it's just stuff like that that's really freaking annoying. So I don't know. I'm really want. Oh, okay. So we're at the concrete pumping stage already. Man, why is my frame rate so jerky today? It's not my frame rate. I'm getting like a solid 55, 56 frames a second while driving towards the city, which is actually pretty good. But it seems like it's lower than that for some reason. I don't know what's going on. I did change my VSync settings. I wonder if that has to do with any, with it. Though I don't notice any screen tearing. So I don't know. Ah, what the heck was that? Some. Did I hit an, I must have hit another car or something. That was weird. Trying to think what else is going on. Not really too much this past week. We got Mad Max and Metal Gear Solid, which I still don't know if I'm going to do series on those. I think I'm about halfway through Mad Max right now, just on my single player game. And it's a fun game, but it's not worth $60. And I don't know what the price of it is currently. I bought it off of G2A. I actually did a pre-order on it, and it was literally like $24.90 something cents. And then with the little G2A protection thing, I think I ended up getting it for like, I don't even know. Like it wasn't much. It was like 25 something. So. And it's worth that for sure. And it might be like worth 30 or $40. But I'm just not sure. The graphics on it are actually pretty darn cool. One of the things I like about it is when you're hold on, let me get into position here. When you are like let's say you're standing on a cliff or something and you're looking at something that looks like it's 2 miles away. There's kind of like this, like the heat haze, the heat shimmer effect, or the heat distortion that you get in a, well, it's an optical illusion. If you live in a hot environment or live somewhere where it can get very hot, you've probably seen the heat rising up off the ground and it creates kind of like this weird shimmering effect. Well, like for an example, like if I look at these mountains way off in the distance, they look a little bit fuzzy because they're at a reduced resolution because they're so far away. But with Mad Max, you can see tons of detail, even though the image is blurry, and it in a way it almost looks like it's a flat image, but it's not. And I've never really seen the exact same effect in a video game before. It's pretty cool, and plus I love the Max Mat the Mad Max universe, even though it would absolutely suck to have to live in those type of conditions. Whoops. I need to open that up. There we go. But some I'd say I'm enjoying the game. There it's slightly repetitive. It's not horribly bad, but it is, I know one of the complaints has been that it's it's repetitive. And there are some aspects of it that are, I mean, in what game these days are there not repetitive aspects, really? But if you ask me, like, what's it like to play, it's very similar to, like, an Assassin's Creed gameplay-wise, not really story-wise, but gameplay-wise, it is. So, anyway, give it a try. I haven't even downloaded Metal Gear Solid yet. I'm really not that pumped about that game. Maybe I'll have a new appreciation for Metal Gear Solid after this, you know, after I play this. But I've watched a couple videos already, and some of the videos just look absolutely ridiculous. Like there's like these balloon things that you extract people with or something, or capture people. I don't know, but you put this pack onto them. It's a balloon, right? And like a little, it's almost like a miniature hot air balloon. But the balloon launches people like into orbit or something. I mean, it occurs so quickly as to be unbelievably ridiculous. Now, I know it's a video game, and video games aren't really supposed to be all that believable. But come on. I haven't even played it, and I'm like, this is so stupid that I'm not sure that... It's basically not... it's not making me want to play the game, so I don't know. We'll have to wait and see on that. I actually have two copies of the game. I might end up giving one away. I just don't know. We'll wait and see. Okay. Let's get the last bit of this done, and we will be done. And you know what I didn't do yet again? Where did my... Oh, there it is. Oh, gosh. Okay. Clear the area. I didn't start my stopwatch, which I always forget to do. So we'll try to get... We've been in the game for, what, like 10 minutes maybe? I don't know. Okay. Let's go turn this guy off. What the crap? What was that? Alright. And this should pretty much put us done with this mission, right? I think it will. So anyway, not really much has been going on. I've been playing Mad Max quite a bit, you know, aside from doing recording. And I've also been playing Far Cry 4. Wow, what the heck? Yeah, I've been... Holy moly. Wow, that was quick. That was an easy job. I've been playing Far Cry 4. I picked it up on G2A also, because I thought, well, you know, I'll play that and see how that is. And actually, you know, quite ended up... I ended up enjoying it, I am enjoying it right now. And I think I'm about halfway through the game, or a little bit more than halfway. I'm at the halfway point on the map, where you can go from, like, the south part of the map to the north part of the map. But, I don't know, the story is still very similar to Far Cry 3, in many ways, and I just don't really like that. You know, it's like whoever writes these stories is just ridiculous. I mean, they can't come up with anything better than that. I don't know. We'll have new jobs in 30 seconds. Okay. Hey, fam, we could do that one. Another Red house there. Ooh, look at this. High-rise apartments. That looks cool. 3, 2, 1. New contracts are available and nothing really. I was expecting there to be like a special job, but new? I do have all the vehicles and everything, as far as I know. I think I even bought that little truck, didn't I? What is that sound? I can't tell if it's in the game or if it's. Sorry. It sounds like there's somebody outside of my house. Anyway, I don't know if I bought one of these yet. Supposedly there's like this big heavy duty trailer. I can't remember what this is used for. It's used for transporting the mobile crane. No, I'm just kidding. So we've got the large escalator. We pretty much have everything. Oh, it's used for transporting the rotary drilling rig. That's what it's used for. And I did buy one of those, didn't I? Isn't it right? Yeah, it's right over here. Look at that thing. That thing is just a monster. But we haven't had a job that needs it yet. Sorry about that. Had to take a swig of water. Okay. Well, darn it. I was hoping we would be able to do maybe that big apartment job, but it does not look like. All right, let's try this one. Excavate the marked area. First of all, I'm not going to be excavating Jack. Because I freaking hate excavating anything. So 25 minutes? You got to be kidding me. It's seriously going to take 25. Wow. Well, that was unexpected. Let's see what other jobs we can get since we can actually do two. Actually, we might even be able to do more. XP level. Okay. Unlock new construction area. Oh, so we need to get this new area unlocked for sure. Average entrepreneur, new con, a new con. Okay, so we need to get up to level 16 to get the new public contract. So, all right. Well, in that case, let's get another job then. Let's see. Not really like that much to do. I don't want to really dig all that much. That's the thing. So let's try this. The house with a patio. So. Oh, great. Okay. So we need to get our lowboy truck and trailer, I think. Okay. Wait a second, wait a second, wait a second. I think I can use this truck. Oh, wonderful. So we're gonna have to get this off of here, I guess. Wait a second. Go, go. Perfect. I could not have done that any better myself. And actually, I did do it myself. So there. Again, you know, the frame rate on this game is still kind of bugging me. But I honestly, I don't expect any more updates to the game engine. I really don't. I really do not. Okay, the large generator should be right up here, so... All right, let's go and get this. What was it, a large generator? Yes. All right. Okay. Oh, there we go. I'm like, why isn't it rotating? I was hitting the wrong button. Nope. There we go. All right. Let's go ahead and attach that. There we are. And go ahead and oh, not this again. There we are. Oh. All right, so we have to take this to construction site number 2. Make sure it is still there. Where is construction site number 2? It's very close to where the last job site was. Okay. I am still shocked that this game plays so absolutely piss poor that I'm only getting 30 frames a second. See, I'm really glad I'm not playing at 60 frames a second right now, because then you guys would actually see how jarring it is to go from 60 frames down, you know, back down to 30. And there are people, I'm telling you, there are people out there that are like, you know, your eyes can't tell more than 30 frames a second. Yes, they can, trust me. I can tell a difference between 144 frames a second and 60 frames a second. Now, I will say that once you get over 100 frames a second or so, it does start to become very difficult to see that. But... you can still kind of notice some differences. Okay, so we'll get our outriggers out. See them going out in the mirror right there, which is good. I'm looking forward to seeing what is the future of Construction Simulator, and kind of see what they come out with as their next big thing. You know, obviously they're going to have to outdo this game. Whoops, I guess I better detach the cargo. You know, they'll have to do better than this game. And I, you know, I would hope that they would add more actual construction tasks other than, like, just delivering things to a job site. But I don't know. We'll see. I've got, you know, I have to say that I've gotten a lot of enjoyment out of this game. I really have. Whoops. Okay, I'm just going to reset this. And what do we have to do? We've got the roller. I'm just going to transport it over to the construction site. We are going to go to, I think it's construction site number 2. Okay. So, this is just about compacting the soil here. Okay. And again, this doesn't have to be perfect. I mean, we can compact the soil outside of the boundaries. This isn't going to be something where we're penalized for, you know, painting outside the lines. Unlike a coloring book, you know, where your parents beat you because you couldn't paint outside the lines. Oh, I just painted outside the lines, Mommy. Wait. No, it's all right. I actually did. I was actually a very good art student, and I would see, I can remember this from like a really young age, and like all my other friends, when they would draw, they would basically just scribble lines, and I was really meticulous, especially with coloring books, because I didn't want to draw outside the lines because I knew it was wrong. Not like, you know, abortion is wrong, or, you know, murdering somebody is wrong, but I just knew that it was not the correct way to do it. And anyway, I used to have coloring books with like these really well colored, you know, scenes, or, you know, whatever you want to call them, pictures. And and, you know, unfortunately, I think they've been lost to time and, you know, the garbage man. But every time I do one of these roller missions, I do think of that. I can't remember if I've mentioned it before or not. I don't think I've really mentioned it to that, you know, to that level of detail of storytelling. But yeah, I did. I actually did. I used to really be like self-conscious about it. And I later went to art school, you know, as a young boy, you know, probably 8. I actually went to the Cincinnati Art Academy from, like, in the summers when I was probably 8 years old to, you know, to, I can't really remember, but I remember going there, like, you know, during the summers. And I can remember there were, like, I was probably the youngest kid in the class for most of the years I went down there. And, I mean, that was cool. It was fine. I didn't have a problem with it. But I can remember, like, the first time going down there, and I was, like, just feeling so out of my element. 'Cause I was, you know, such a young kid there. All right, so let's take this back home. Now we need a concrete mixer, which should be just right around the corner. Actually, it literally is right around the corner. Look at that. Look at that. We're right there, guys. Okay. Whoops. Put our outriggers out. I feel like a big spider. Speaking of spiders, I was sitting here in my computer room yesterday, and a gigantic spider went up my wall. Now, it wasn't too gigantic. It was probably about 2 inches across. I think it was like a smaller wolf spider, or a type of wolf spider. They're not particularly dangerous or anything like that. They're just kind of big looking, and when they get really big, they're a little bit hairy, and they're kind of scary looking. So anyway, I saw this spider, and I went to get a tissue to either squish it or capture it so I could put it outside. Yeah, I've already heard it from all the rest of my friends, who all just say I'm crazy and that I should kill the thing. And again, I've probably told you guys this before, but I try not to kill things when I don't absolutely have to. And I kind of think of it as, you know, if I was on a planet, like if I went to Mars and I'm an explorer and some big gigantic alien came over and just stepped on me, I'd you know, and killed me, I don't know that I would be happy about it because I would be dead and we don't know what happens when we die. But I can imagine that if I did have feelings about it, I would not be a happy camper. So I try not to kill things, and maybe it's karma, I don't know. But I try not to. So I'm sitting there trying to cup a piece of paper underneath this little guy. And, oh, is my, okay, my, the thing's empty. And so I'm trying to get him so that I can kind of like put him into this piece of paper. And the guy, like, the little guy, like, does this high jump pole vault maneuver. I mean, literally, he jumped up over the top of where my hand and the tissue was. And he flew down, well, he didn't flee, he fell down into the floor. I, like, jumped back and screamed like a five-year-old girl. And I literally did, like, you know, just imagine, like, a little girl going, ah! I can't even scream, but I'm telling you, if the spider came out right now, I would probably scream. And, no, I'd probably be like, oh! So maybe I'm finally to that age where I don't actually scream like a five-year-old girl. Anyway, I'm not a terrible... I'm not a huge fan of spiders by any stretch. Anyway, to make a long story short, the spider disappeared into oblivion. I have no clue where he is. I wish him no harm. I would like him to leave my home. So if spider, if you're listening, I would like you to leave, and I will not kill you if you leave or if you come voluntarily. But it was kind of creepy. I think I told the story a long time ago. Actually, I don't know if it was this year or last year, the way time worked. I think it was early this year. There was a wolf spider type of spider in my house. And in the middle of the night, I stepped on it with bare feet when my lights were off. I was coming into the office because I was laying in bed. And I'm like, oh, crap, I forgot to upload my video. And I came in and accidentally stepped on and killed the spider. And I felt really bad about it. Because, again, I'm the big alien stepping on his world, you know. And I'm afraid I might do that again. But it still gives me the heebie-jeebies. Like, I was falling asleep last night, and I'm like, man, I really hope he doesn't crawl into my mouth in the middle of the night. I have a really weird story about something like that, though. Years ago, I woke up one morning, and I had... You know, you normally have morning breath, right? And I had, like, the worst taste in my mouth. It was like this really super... It was just kind of like this weird acidic taste, I guess. I didn't know what the heck it was. And I got up, and I'm like, I'm like, I got to brush my teeth as soon as, like, sometimes, you know, in the morning you might be a little bit lazy and you might not brush your teeth, like, right off the bat. But, oh, man, this morning, I was like, I went right in. So I go in and I kind of, like, you know how you do, you kind of, like, I kind of spit any saliva in my mouth out into the sink and wash it away. So I spit into the sink, and there's like this black stuff in the sink, and I'm sitting there looking at it like, I don't know what that is, but I really hope that that's not chewed up spider that came in, you know, and got into my mouth in the middle of the night, because that would just be absolutely atrociously disgusting. And it, by all means, it could have been. I have no idea to this day. I brushed my teeth like 5 times in a row. I think I, you know, went through like 5 cups of mouthwash. I don't know. I'm not being serious about that. But it, whatever it was freaking disgusting. It was, something was in my mouth. You know, it could have been something simple. Like maybe I ate an Oreo cookie before I went to bed and didn't brush my teeth. And, which is equal, well, no, that's even, not even that is equally gross. It's gross, but not that gross. So, I just hope that I didn't eat a spider, that's all I'm saying. I really, really hope I didn't eat a spider. Ugh. Anyway. Okay. Large, okay, let's have... Let's have this guy deliver that. And how's this other dude doing? Says he's 72% complete with excavating. Gosh, it's been 18 minutes and 5 seconds already. Ah, sorry about that. Had to take another drink. Let's see. Are we going to have to pour concrete? Yes, we will. Concrete and then roofing tiles. Okay. Well, Let's get out of the truck here. I actually want to see where I'm going to be working at here. Oh, look. Oh, it's actually like an apartment building. That's pretty cool. Now, if you put your crane in the backyard, how in the monkey are you going to get it out of there? Especially with this big wall here. It's like, oh, we can just take it down there, no problem. I guess you could, you know, set up something here and crane it over there, but still... let's see here. Let's look. Man, this has got a bunch of stages to it. Rebar. Don't know how long that's going to take. Or concrete. Okay. So... Yeah, we're just going to have to see, you know, where that goes, or, you know, where am I running down the street here? Concrete pump. Okay, so now it's kind of boring. We're just kind of sitting around, not really doing anything, just waiting for... the next bit to get done so that we can pour some more concrete, I guess. And then we'll move everything over to the other construction point. Should be a few minutes for that. Da, da, da. So let's see. Aside from eating spiders and yes, I don't know. The little spider guy, he's around in here somewhere. I hope he didn't crawl inside my computer because that would really not make me happy. He's probably behind my filing cabinet. I have like this black filing cabinet that my computer's actually sitting on top of. It's like a big, like a metal filing cabinet, like a two drawer. And he's probably back in there because it's dark. My filing cabinet is black. So back in the corner, it should be extra dark and scary and whatnot. So I don't know. I wish him all the best. I just do not wish him anywhere near me. Another drink of water. And come on, we're almost finished. Look at that. It's. I don't know. I don't know, kids. What did he have to get? Like rebar or something like that? Doesn't say. Okay. Whoa. Okay. Yep. Now we're just pouring more concrete. Helps if I do this. Oh, look, the stairs going up. Okay. Okay. And I guess I can't bring that in. Man, I was hoping I'd be able to bring this in a little bit more. But no. All right. No big deal. Still be able to get our completion without it, even though we are going to have to fill up the concrete here in a moment. There are we doing on this job? Okay, 95% complete. That is not the concrete truck. This is for the cement truck. Cement or concrete? Cement. Gosh, you guys are pervs. Oh, boogers. I need to open up the little concrete flap there on the back. Should have opened it. Yes, it did. What was that? Okay. Come on, bring it in. Okay, let's do. See, state. Whoops. Can I hire that worker? Yes. Oops. New contracts available. The only contracts I really want are the public ones, but oh gosh. Okay. So, what's this last bit? Big roof tiles. We'll hire a worker to come and deliver those, since that's what they're there for. Okay. So this is going to have to go over to the new construction site, which I think is like right up here on the left. That's a few more blocks down on the left. Come on. Why does it always feel so much different driving from a isolinear view behind the truck to actually driving from the cockpit or the cabin of the truck, the cab? I don't understand. It's like a totally different feeling for some reason. I don't know why. But it is. Uh-oh. Poor concrete. Perfect. Made it just in time. Okay. So now it becomes the large, arduous process of turning this thing around. Okay. Oh, so this has like a basement in it. That's pretty cool. This is like the worst concrete job I've ever done. Look at that. Ah. Uh-oh, somebody's done. Let's go get our concrete mixer. And then once I get this stage done, I'm going to have to check on time, because like I said, I didn't start my stopwatch right away. So we're going to have to see how we're doing on time, making sure, you know, we're about, you know, an hour or so. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. You know, I wish I had like a parking brake, you know, so I could do like a really hard turn, a really hard U-turn. But can't. Hey. Dadgummit, I forgot to open that little trap. I do it every time. Open. See if we can kind of get this over a little bit more. And start pouring, make sure the flow is good, and then we can jump out and get stuck. Oh, there we go. Okay. See, I'm not sure if like the concrete mixing bucket would actually work better in this case with the tower crane, you know what I mean? I don't know if it would work better. So we can try to do like a big semicircle like this. I'm just kind of going in like a big circular motion here. And yeah, I know I just poured concrete all over the stairs. But you know what? That's the way it goes in the big city of Fuchsburg. Because who gives a fook? Nobody gives a fook in Fuchsburg. Come on. Get in there. Okay, let's get these extra bits. Okay. Looks like there's like vines going, you know, growing down inside. It's like we're in the jungle. Least that's what I get the feeling of a little bit. Why do I still have rebar showing down there at the bottom? Well, at the right, I guess. Fill this up a little bit. There we go. Okay. Oh yeah. We'll be able to do much better here. I don't like the way the sun is in this game. Like, the sun position never moves. So I'm in the shade. Which I guess would be nice. Okay, clear the concrete pump. Alright. Alright. Drive to a building materials. Okay, this part I actually am going to have to do. Because I think we have to get some walls or something like that. Let's see here. Okay, so what do I have to do? I have to get drive. Oh no, okay. We will have a hired worker do that. While I take a drink of refreshing water. And I'm going to just tab out of my game really quick. Okay, so we're at 56 minutes right now. So that's pretty much going to be, you know, all we're going to be able to do for this episode today. We'll hang around for a moment. We'll take a look and see what this new bit is going to do. Let's go see if I can go. Oh, dude, I can go down. Can go down into the basement. I wonder if these are like going to be apartments, like really tiny apartments, or maybe like storage units for the apartments above. I would say storage units or something, because these don't really strike me as being very apartment-like. But we'll have to come back in the next episode and continue on. So I'll try to do an episode this Thursday for Construction Sim. Last week I did another Millennium Falcon video where I just mainly did some painting with the airbrush and some other things. And and then I did Euro Truck Sim. So I do plan on wanting to do more Euro Truck. Now the kids are going back to school. The views on my channel are going to drop off a bit. So I kind of have to see what my views are going to look like over the next couple weeks to see, you know, which ones are, you know, most people are liking. Because, you know, I want to do the more popular ones for you guys. And if you guys like the videos, you know, I want to be sure that, you know, I'm making videos that you guys like and not really ones that you don't. So we are almost finished with this next little bit. Come on. Oh, I just noticed we're over 2 million. This is really hard to do with the keyboard. I'm actually doing this on a keyboard. Now I can do it on my controller. Whoa! I do the happy dance. I don't even know what that means. Okay. So I'm just kind of checking out these apart, you know, these rooms. Man, that would be a tiny, maybe this is like a bathroom. Because this just seems way too small to be like a bedroom. Yeah, see, this is like a bedroom. And this is kind of like, your kitchen would be probably over here with like a living room here or something. And then your bedroom and a bathroom. This would be an incredibly small apartment, though. And then, oh, well, there's actually going to be another floor to it, too. So we're going to have to come back and pump some more concrete in the next episode. But thank you again for watching, guys. As always, I greatly appreciate all the support I get from you guys. Please don't forget to hit that like and share button. Helps my channel grow tremendously. Just hit 18,000 subscribers Friday before last. So what is that, 9 days ago, and we're already closing in on 18,500. So that's pretty cool. You know, things are still growing and moving along, and I was just going to pull up the to see, because I haven't actually looked all day. I'm kind of to the point where I just don't look really at my my channel growth because it just grows so quickly. Yeah, I'm at 18,454, so we're almost to 18,500. We'll probably be there sometime, maybe tomorrow or really early Monday. And, you know, again, we're going to hit 19,000 before the end of September. And, gosh, I cannot believe I'm going to have 20,000 subscribers here soon. That is just amazing. If you guys have any ideas about what you'd like me to do for 20,000, if you want me to do like a question and answer, or I don't know, I'm up for ideas because 20,000 is a pretty big milestone, you know, like 10,000. So let me know if you guys have any ideas. Please post them in the comments section. I am all ears, and we will see you back for more. This is not Farming Simulator, Construction Simulator 2015. I am Brad M73, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye for now.